Greetings, friend. The latest update to Lightroom includes an interesting new feature that uses artificial intelligence to eliminate reflections from photographs taken through plate glass windows with a single click. Reflection removal is not something that you are going to use every day, and the first version of this tool is not flawless. But when it works, this new feature is fascinating, and it can turn photos that you might have deleted into something worth sharing. AI-powered reflection removal is pretty straightforward, so let's jump right in and let's get started. Here's an example that I shot one evening through the windows of a train in Japan. My eyes clearly saw the passengers standing outside on the train platform, but my camera did not. What my camera captured was a combination of the exterior scene plus a hazy reflection of the train's interior. So check this out. With the latest version of Lightroom Classic installed, when I open up the Remove tool, there's a new panel called Distraction Removal. Once this panel is open, I'm going to tap on the Apply button, and then a brand new type of artificial intelligence will do its magic. Wow. Let me split my screen so that you can see a full side-by-side comparison between our two images. The AI here identified the reflected areas, and it removed them from the finished product. That's too cool. So let me show you another example. Here, we have a menu that I shot through a restaurant window. Only after taking this photo did I realize that the glass window acted like a mirror, and so the results that my camera captured are barely readable. But if I go to that new Remove tool to Distraction Removal, and I turn on the Apply button, then barely readable becomes this. But wait, there's more. A lot of what artificial intelligence does is a mystery. But in this case, Adobe intentionally gave us a way to peel back the curtain and to see the machine's thought process. To understand what I'm about to show you, we need to recognize that a photograph that's polluted by reflection is essentially the sum of two different images. The first image is the scene that you actually want to capture. And the second image? Well, that's a reflection of the scene behind me. The second image is weaker and hazy because the window glass only reflects a portion of the light that hits it. When we run this command, the computer tries to identify these two images. If I bring the amount slider down to 0, then we'll see our original image. As we bring this slider up, we're telling Lightroom to show us more and more of the image without the reflection. But here's the mind-blowing part. If I bring the amount slider down below 0, then we're telling Lightroom that what we want to see is more and more of the reflection. At the negative 100 setting, I'm seeing the street scene behind me, and Lightroom is showing us almost none of the menu that lives on the other side of the glass. Detangling the intended image from the unwanted reflection, that's the kind of task that requires machine learning and pattern recognition. If you're still interested, let's hop over to two more quick examples. I want to point out that there are places that I love to photograph that are always challenging. Museums are often very hard places to make good images because we are always shooting through glass and we cannot control the lighting. This is the kind of photo that I might have deleted in the past, but now, when I run the new Remove Reflection algorithm, much of the unwanted image goes away. But unfortunately, we also lose some of the sharpness. Fortunately, Adobe gives us a choice here. If I up this quality setting from Preview to Best, and I let the AI recalculate, then the end result is a much sharper image. See, this quality menu offers us three levels of edge crispness. The higher the quality setting, the sharper the final image. But producing those crisper results takes more processing power and more time. Adobe is giving us all three options here, since AI-powered reflection removal can be hit or miss. This is why I usually start at preview quality on most images. I usually experiment with this feature at its draft setting to see if it works at all. Once I'm convinced that it's improving my image, then I can increase the quality setting to standard or best when I need sharper results. Okay, let's talk Lightroom workflow real quick. Adobe says that it doesn't matter whether you use remove reflections before or after you crop your image. Likewise, the order of operations for standard non-AI adjustments like the exposure, the tone controls, or the white balance shouldn't cause you any problems when working with the new remove reflections command. Things can get weird though if you stack one AI-based tool on top of another. If I use the generative remove tool to remove these vents in the floor, and then if I remove the reflections, we'll end up with strange stripes where the floor vents used to be. The problem is that the floor was one color when I ran the generative remove command, but the color of the floor, and in fact the whole image, has changed once the reflection is gone. Fortunately, Lightroom is aware that using more than one type of AI tool can cause problems, which is why this new AI status indicator has turned yellow. If I click here, then a box will appear warning us about this potential pitfall. In addition, this new box has an update button. The update tells Lightroom to recalculate the color of those generative remove areas, and now everything looks good. After that change, I may need to come back in here and adjust some of these other settings as well. Not only is remove reflections a welcome addition, but this new AI status indicator is a big improvement. Anyway, using all of these tools, we have gone from this to this in no time. Well, there you go. With just a few clicks, you can now rescue some of those shots that were marred by reflections. This new technology is not perfect, but I'm convinced that it will get better and better, and that it is a sign of even more amazing things to come. I hope that you found this tutorial helpful. If you learned something today, then please leave us a like or a comment down below. And don't forget to subscribe to this channel. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in our next tutorial.